The Uncrewed Triple Challenge is a competition to move a 10-pound package across three domains: sea, air, and land. We have businesses from all of the uncrewed systems. A lot of small businesses, medium-sized businesses, and they have their technology that they're coming here to really evaluate and test in the rigors of the competition.
And this is a place where you can really show how your stuff works in the wild, if you will.
This is the National All-Domain Warfighting Center. Not only open water, a large volume of airspace and land, and then the access for cyberspace and space technologies, all resident in Northeast Michigan. And it provides a very low risk environment for people to come and test experimental systems and integrate that with not only soldiers here on the ground or sailors, Marines, and airmen, but also commercial uses as well.
Today was a great example of seeing innovation happening during the course. Once you get into that natural element, spectators watching, anything then can happen.
And these systems were doing it some autonomously without human intervention. Some were doing it with minimal human intervention. And that's exactly what the Uncrewed Triple Challenge is about.
Innovation for the military looks like working hand in hand with the commercial sector. Commercial strategy is incredibly important. We've got to deploy the cutting edge technology better, faster, cheaper for the military. We see the military and the DoD as not an end state, but as a catalyst to promote industrialization of the country. So the objective here is for startups and entrepreneurs to be able to design, prototype, test, validate, deploy, demonstrate, and also full-scale production manufacturing all in one place. And you can do that within a four-hour drive in Michigan, which is a huge thing. I'm not seeing a lot of other states do this. These all kind of contribute to a larger innovation economy.
Michigan wants to be a leader in uncrewed systems. It's of great benefit not only to the citizens of Michigan, creating jobs, but it also improves the quality of life for people that are using these things for hard to reach places such as medicine delivery in remote areas, transport of goods and services, medication, and also it's helping promote public safety and security. These systems are able to respond right away, for instance, in the air, to an emergency on the ground to better inform first responders of what they need to bring or what's occurring on the scene to help save people's lives.
If we can bring those who are innovating at those smaller and mid-sized companies and working with those manufacturers and working with those supply chains, that's a win for everybody.